Hey everybody, I'm here today to show you and tell you how to self-adjust your shoulder blades. This will be an easy tutorial, so let's get right into the video. First and foremost, I'm not a professional. This is just what I do to self-adjust my shoulder blades. It should not cause you any discomfort or any pain. If it causes you any discomfort or any pain at all, go seek help from a professional. And that's basically it. This is just my own opinion. I just had to get that out of the way just to let you know I'm not a pro. This is just what I do. It's my opinion on what works for me. Let's get right into the video. I'm gonna show you three movements that I use all the time to self-adjust my shoulder blades, okay? The first one is very simple, okay? I'm just gonna pull my pants up over here. What you wanna do is you wanna essentially get your hands like this, place them behind your back, and interlock them like that, okay? And what you're gonna do is you're gonna sort of pull them away from your body and back. And I'm gonna come closer to the camera because you might end up hearing a crack or a popping sound. And I wanna make that very clear that that's the self-adjustment happening. So let's see what we can do here. Let's just pull them away from our body like this, just like that. I'll show you what it looks like. Just like that, and then you can lean back a little bit like that and pull them away like that, not too far. Like I said, you don't want it to cause you any discomfort. Even if you don't get a crack or a popping sound from that, you're still adjusting your shoulder blades. You can see I have a much better range of motion right now. Much, much, much better range of motion, okay? The second version of that that we're gonna do is very similar, except our hands are gonna be above our, behind our head. So I can take my hands like this, behind my head like this, okay, open up my elbows as far as I can from each other like this, and then just take our head and sort of just tilt it back like that. Okay, just like that. And it's really gonna open up your shoulder blades. If you see what it looks like from behind, my shoulder blades are really opening up just like that, okay? Ah, and then release, just like that. Feels fantastic. The third thing that you can do, like I said, you don't wanna push yourself to the point of any pain or discomfort. It should alleviate the pain, right? That's like when I do it, it makes me feel better. So you want to, your goal is to alleviate the pain, not push your shoulders to the point where it causes you discomfort or pain. Just get them to open up and sort of get them to the point where they're gonna be adjusted properly to be the way they need to be. The final thing that we're gonna do is very simple. It's basically, we're gonna go to a doorway or a wall or anything that you can push off against, okay? It doesn't have to be a window. You can do it directly against the wall, which I'll show you in a minute. But what you're gonna do is take your hand, place it like this against the window or the door frame or any surface, and then you wanna take your body like this and you wanna walk forward a little bit and sort of get that shoulder pulling back, but not too much. We're not walking, we're not leaning very far forward. Go a little bit, see how far you can go. Go a little bit further if you can, a little bit further if you can, just like that. Okay, and we're keeping our hand in this position right here, okay? The other way that you can do it is directly against the wall, which I'll demonstrate right now. If I go against the wall, I wanna place my arm like that, flat against the wall, and then I can just rotate my body. Hopefully you can see this, let me see, yeah? You can just rotate your body, sort of stretch that shoulder back just like that, okay? And you can hold it there for a few seconds, and then release it just like that. Really gonna improve your range of motion, and you might get a few cracks and pops out of that, a few self-adjustments where things are getting in place, but at the bare minimum, you're gonna get a better range of motion. And lastly, there's one other move which we can do, which is very simple, and that's sort of, this is like an added bonus, because probably won't cause any self-adjustment, but it is great for your stretching and range of motion. Take your hands like this, place them above your head, and sort of just, I'm using one hand to pull the other up. We're gonna just alternate. So I'm using my left hand to pull my right hand up like that, and now I'm using my right hand to pull my left hand up like that. There we go. Just a couple times, and it will really just help you self-adjust those shoulders. That's it. Like I said, I didn't get any cracks or pops out of this self-adjustment, but you don't have to. You know, self-adjustment is not only about cracking and popping things and stuff like that. It's about stretching and improving your range of motion as well. So that's basically it. Like I said, I'm not a professional. This is just my opinion on what works for me. I have no level of professionalism or research involved in chiropractics or self-adjustment. It is just, this is just the stuff that works for me, and I figured that I'd share it with you, and it should not cause you any discomfort or pain. If it causes you any discomfort or pain, stop immediately and seek help from a professional. That's it. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment, and of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.